Welcome to Hay House's Meditations with Anthony Williams, Soul Healing Meditations.
So today we're talking about meditation and prayer. So now let's start getting into it. Let's start talking about this. So why would we even need to meditate? You know, why? Why bother? Why? Why would we even need to? Because let's be honest, because planet stress is really difficult. Did I say planet stress? I mean, planet Earth is really, really difficult to be on. And, you know, look, I would be lying to you or just really playing with you if I said it wasn't a stressful place down here, if we didn't get challenged and we didn't get pushed to our max. And, you know, no one has an easy life down here. It may seem like it is. It may seem like people do. And true, we go through struggles, we go through different trials in our life, and some people seem to be, you know, left alone and moving forward in their life. But in the end, no matter what, in our lifetime, we get challenged with something along the way. Some get challenged earlier, in the middle, in the ends. It's, you know, it's not easy here. It just comes no matter what. So we need to meditate. Meditation is a way to bring something back into us that we're missing. Look, everybody is soul searching. We know that, right? Everybody is soul searching. A midlife crisis, you know, that's a really funny thing. Like when someone's having a midlife crisis, you know, the funny thing about that is really what that is someone soul searching. That's what it is. Someone is soul searching, but they may be doing different techniques of soul searching. You can have a beginning life crisis too. Do you ever meet anybody they've had more than a midlife crisis? It seemed like all through their lives, they've had these different constant shifts. So they've had this beginning life crisis towards the middle, towards the end. So it just keeps coming. It's soul searching. Whether we know it or not, whether we even know it or someone even told us, everyone is soul searching. You know, even if they're not aware of it. Because we feel like maybe something's missing in our lives. You know, do you feel like you've missed out on anything? You know, sometimes I get like that. I'm like, well, am I missing out on something? Am I missing out on something? You know, and so that's a big part of it too. It's why we look out for inspirational speakers, therapists. We go to therapists. We go and we look for leaders. We look for experts, gurus. We seek these people out because we're looking for guidance. We're looking for direction. We're looking for answers. We're looking for a place of being. No? Yeah, for sure. Because we're trying to become grounded. We're trying to gain a foundation. We go on retreats. We explore. We go searching. We run over hot coals, right? You've heard about that? I wouldn't do that. I'm not going to run over a whole trail of burning hot coals. But you know, there's some brave, brave people who do it just because they're trying to, they're soul searching. That's what it is. It's actually, believe it or not, it's kind of a form of meditation too, in a way. So, you know, chances are if I was going to do that, I'd stop in the middle of it because spirit would be giving me a read of everybody around me and what's going on with their health. And I might all of a sudden stop and stand there on the burning coal. So I wouldn't do that. But the bottom line is we're looking to become grounded. And so we soul search because we feel losses. We feel we soul search when we have a loss of objects, like when we have to give away that car that we've had so long. You know, we have to give away that motorcycle. You know, the strangest things. I mean, even objects. Some people say objects are objects. That's That's nothing compared to other things we can lose. That doesn't even hold a candle to some things, but you'd be surprised. I've seen people, you know, tragically in a depression because they lost an object in their life, material object. And, you know, and so it happens to all kinds of people and what's, you know, what's going on in their life. I've seen people need to meditate because they lost a little sacred gem that their grandmother passed down to them and it was missing. And it took a few years to meditate that one off because it was so hard. So we, you know, and then we lose friends. We lose friends for one reason or another sometimes when we go through life. And then we lose loved ones. And that's when we question everything. That's when we question everything. When we lose a loved one and that loss, you know, because a loved one's passed, crossed over, that's when we start questioning, whoa, everything. The universe, heaven, our life here, our purpose here, our soul, everything under the sun, we're questioning, you know. And so is meditation important? Is it something critical? Is it something we need? Do we even need it? No, yeah, we do. And prayer as well, just as important. So when we encounter these hardships, and you know, hey, you know what I'm talking about, right? I mean, just chronic illness alone is a hardship. There's no doubt we get challenged with it. I mean, for sure. So you know what I mean. And when we get tested down here, when we encounter these hardships, our soul can become stressed. Stress fractures on the soul. It could be tested. The soul gets tested. It gets pushed, and it gets pushed hard. And so we get tested on planet stress. I got to stop saying planet stress. It's planet Earth. So today we're going to be meditating and making it beautiful planet Earth. That's what we're going to be doing today. All right. You know, I mean, and so down here on this planet, we got divorces. We got responsibilities. We get our health gets tested. We get with struggles of all kinds of different kinds. And losses and struggles propel and push us to want to soul search even more and want to get grounded even more than ever before so we can thrive down here. You know, meditation techniques helps us release the past. It is one thing about meditation techniques that we're going to talk about is the whole present moment thing. I'm going to release some information that's really important to know about that. But meditation techniques helps us release the past. It helps us claim the life that we feel, you know, we deserve, that we feel we should have. You know, it connects us to God. It connects us to the higher source. It connects us to the light, to the great divine. Connects us to the universe, right? Meditation helps us rewire, like all those wires, which are really neurons, you know, glial cells, electrical impulses, you know, brain tissue, all of that rewiring. Meditation helps us rewire. It helps us to adapt. That's what it does. Adapting. Adapting's critical. That's a big deal. Is having to adapt with everything, especially with the faster times. You know, I put in my book that I just put it, that, it, you know, we're releasing here. And I talk about how there's this quickening occurring and things are happening faster and how we have to adapt. That's really a big part of it. Meditation helps you adapt. We can keep up with everything. Readjust. It helps us to readjust. So we have all these challenges here, and we all face hardships, but meditation is like a key, a golden key. It strengthens us so we can rise out of the ashes. Yeah, exactly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.